Good afternoon, students. Welcome to English class, class 10. In previous class, we have discussed about the grammar, that is fill in the blanks with A or AM. In the previous class, we have discussed about only A and AM, where we have to use A, AM, and I have told you the also, where we have to use the, A, article, and I told you which are going to be called as definite article and indefinite article. Definite article is the, indefinite article is A, I, AM. Here you can see the page number 13. B. Fill in the blanks with A, AM or the wherever necessary. Fill in the blanks with A, AM or the wherever necessary means some of the blanks are not used by the articles. They told that wherever necessary, you use A, AM, AND, THE. Wherever necessary, note there are some blanks where an article is not required. Some of the blanks are there which are written on the blackboard. Some of the blanks are there, there article is not needed. So you have to find out and search that and find that wherever the article is necessary, that is A, AM and THE, there you fill the gaps. And some of the blanks are there, their article is not necessary. That also you have to keep in your mind. I told you where you want to use A, AM and THE. We should not see only the vowel sign consonant. We should see the sounds. Sounds of vowels and consonant. If vowel sound is used but the alphabet is consonant, there you have to use AN. I have given you some examples in the previous class. And in some of the examples, there is a consonant sound is there but vowel is used. Vowel is used. So there also you should keep in your mind that we should not use consonant, but we have to use according to the sound of the word. So let us see the bit B. Fill in the blanks with A, AM or the wherever necessary. There are some blanks where an article is not required. Just let us see the first one. There is dash fly in dash coffee. There is dash fly in dash coffee. First, F-L-Y fly, there is fly means here consonant is there. So we have to use A. There is a fly in the coffee. In the coffee. There is a fly in the coffee. You know that why you use the here. Where we have to use the, I discussed in the previous class only. Then second one, dash book. You wanted is not in the library. Dash book. Dash book you wanted is not in the library. Here B is a consonant. But we are going to write a book here. No, for the books, for the holy books or for the name of the rivers, mountains, name of the papers, we are going to use the. That is the reason we use here the. The book you wanted is not in the library. The book you wanted is not in the library. Third one, dash cow is dash useful animal. You are going to write the cow is the useful animal. Name of an animal, that is the cow is a useful, again useful. Which sound here? U is a oval, but which sound that is? Y-O-U, useful. Y means, Y is a consonant. That is the reason we are going to use a here. Then next we come for the fourth example. Dash Mount Everest is dash tallest peak in dash Himalaya. Dash Mount Everest is dash tallest peak in Himalaya. See, 1, 2, 3 gaps they have given. So which article you have to use? First one, in the first one that is Mount Everest, we don't know the name which Mount Everest that is. So here there is no article. There is no article used in the first blank. Mount Everest is, because here there is no need. The sentence used to start from the year, because the Mount Everest is tallest, third degree this is. Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the, again the, because Himalaya is the name. Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the Himalaya. Leave this gap and read it once again. Just you think that any article is necessary here, because the sentence used to start from here. Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the Himalaya. You can understand the meaning of the sentence. Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the Himalaya. Okay, just we feel the here. The Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the Himalaya. Is this sentence is right? No, because the sentence is going to start from here. Mount Everest is the tallest peak in the Himalaya. That is the reason there is no article is used in the first gap. Fourth one. Next come fifth one. Where is Esther? Question mark is there here. Where is Esther? She has gone dash school. Fifth one. Where is Esther? She has gone to. Just to see here, any article is used here. Just to think yourself, if there is no to means, there in the gap we have to use to. But that is to is not an article. Where is Esther? She has gone to school. Already complete sentence is given. Here, there is no article. Already complete sentence is given. She has gone to school. She has gone to market. She has gone to somewhere. She has gone to temple. There is no article is used here, because already the complete sentence, the meaningful sentence they have given already. That is the reason they are not going to use any article there. Then comes to sixth one. Dash Kaveri flows into dash Bay of Bengal. Here you know that name of a river, name of the Mount Everest, name of the peaks, name of the any name, that is name of the papers, that is used as a the article is used. That is definite article the is used. The name of a river is there. So which article is to be used here? The Kaveri. The Kaveri flows into, again Bay of Bengal, flows into the Bay of Bengal. The Kaveri flows into the Bay of Bengal, because both names are mentioned here. Kaveri and Bay of Bengal. That is, there is a no doubt, without doubt we have to write. That is definite article, that is the. So next comes to sixth one. I love stories from dash Ramayana and dash Mahabharata. I love stories from dash Ramayana and Mahabharata. You know that name of the great epics, that is Ramayana and Mahabharata. We know that we have to use the here. From the Ramayana and the Mahabharata. The next goes, eighth one. Eighth example, Hamlet. Hamlet is the name of a English poet, we say. Hamlet is dash greatest tragedy of dash Shakespeare. Hamlet is dash greatest tragedy of dash Shakespeare. The Hamlet is written by the Shakespeare. Hamlet is greatest. Which article we have to use here? Hamlet is the greatest tragedy of Shakespeare. Hamlet is the greatest tragedy of Shakespeare. Just you think any article is going to be used before Shakespeare? Because already the sentence is completed. Hamlet is the greatest tragedy of Shakespeare. Complete sentence is there. There is no article is to be used. The next comes to 9th one. Joshua plays dash piano well. So his parents bought him dash new piano. Joshua plays dash piano well. So his parents bought him a new piano. Joshua plays the piano well. So his parents bought him a new piano. Then 10th one. The climax is in dash 10th chapter, not in dash chapter. The climax is in, which article is used here? The climax is in the 10th chapter, not in 9th chapter, not in chapter 9. So which article is used there? The climax is in the 10th chapter, not in chapter 9. Here we are not going to use any article. Eleventh one, my uncle who was very ill last week is still in dash hospital. If you go to dash hospital, you can see him. The gaps there, here also they have given two blanks. That is, my uncle who was very ill last week is still in. Which article we are going to use here? Go to the hospital. If you go to hospital, here no article is used. Week is still in hospital. Still in hospital. If you go to the hospital, you can see him. Next, 12th one. I am going to dash market to buy vegetables. You cannot come with me because you have to go to dash school. That is 12th one. I am going to market. This is complete sentence here. That's the reason there is no article. I am going to temple. I am going to somewhere. There is no article. It's used to buy vegetables. Why I am going to market? I am going to market to buy vegetables. You cannot come with me because you have to go to the school, you have to go to temple. There is no article is used. We have discussed in the previous class also. Next, 13th one. Dad is aunt coming with uncle. There is a question mark. Dad is aunt coming with uncle. Question mark is there. In the both the blanks, there is no article is used because the complete sentence is, if the sentence is, they have given complete sentence. So there is no article is used in the 13th one. 14th one, dash kindness is a great virtue. I cannot forget dash kindness he showered on me. The sentence used to start from the kindness. We have seen one more example here. That is 4th one, Mount Everest. The sentence starts from the Mount Everest. Here also the sentence is starting from the kindness. Kindness is a a great virtue. I cannot forget the kindness he showed on me. Then last one, 15th one, dash English is a universal language. I learnt English at dash school. Here also in the first blank there is no article is used because the sentence is to start from English is a universal language. Why a is used there? Why not an? Because u is pronounced as y-o-u. That is the reason a is used. English is a universal language. I learnt English at dash school. I learnt English at school. There is no article is used in the 15th blank, that is at, after at. There is no article is used. So let us discuss the C1. So next bit is C bit. Fill in the blanks with suitable preposition. In the previous class you have learnt what is preposition and kinds of preposition, where to use this preposition. Let us just see what is preposition. The name itself mentions that preposition. Pre means before. The position before which is used is called as the preposition. This is general definition we can say. But grammatically what is the meaning of preposition is preposition which is going to be have the relation with noun or pronoun, which is going to be used, which has a relation with noun or pronoun. By adding or by joining with the preposition, it's going to give a complete sense of that sentence. We can say preposition means position means his position, we can say its position. It is going to be used pre, that is called as preposition. We have discussed in the previous class, that is about preposition of time, preposition, so many kinds of prepositions are there. Let us see here, let us try to fill up the gaps with the suitable preposition. Fill in the blanks with suitable preposition. Which preposition is to be suited there? First we have to understand the meaning of the sentence. That is very necessary here. We should know the whatever we are going to fill in the gap, or it may be the article, or it may be the preposition, or it may be the conjunction. First you have to understand the meaning, what they have given the sentence, meaning of that sentence. Here let us see the first sentence. This table is made dash wood. This table is made dash wood. Which preposition is used here? This table is made dash wood. Kisse bana hai ye table? This table is made up of, we can say, or made of wood. See here, which relation it is going to be said here? We said that this is a relation between the noun and the pronoun. Here, which is noun here? Which is noun here? It is the table, and the wood is the remaining part of the sentence, we can say. There is a relation between table and the wood. Table kisse bana hai? Table wood se bana hai. There is a relation of the table and the wood. This table is made of wood. The complete sentence is this table is made of wood. After writing of only, it has a complete meaning. You read without of here, this table is made wood. It gives any meaning? No, there is no meaning without of here. By writing of, this table is made of wood. Means the table which is there, that is made up of wood. Then second one, I expected dash him a better performance. Second one is I expected dash him a better performance. Which preposition is going to be used? I expected from him. I expected from him a better performance. किससे मैं expect कर रहा हूँ यहाँ पे better performance? I expected him. Him is a person. I is here. It's a pronoun. I is a pronoun. I expected from him. I expected from him. उससे मैं क्या expect कर रहा हूँ? Better performance. There is a relationship between I and the him. We don't know who is him here. There is a relationship between I and him here. Then let's come to the third one. He is a man dash a fine sense of humor. He is a man. What type of man he is? He is a man with a fine sense of humor. Means he can remember everything. Sense of humor we can say. He is a man with a fine sense of humor. Then fourth one, I saw a beautiful girl dash a limp. Fourth one is, I saw a beautiful girl with a, how the girl is? I saw a beautiful girl with a limp. Then fifth one, the purse fell out of his pocket. The purse is in his pocket and the purse fell out of his pocket. Then sixth one is, she often quotes Shakespeare. Any preposition is used here? She often quotes Shakespeare. Means some of the quotations we are going to take from the Shakespeare. Here there is no preposition is used. Seventh one, our examinations begins dash 15th April. Our examinations begin dash 15th April. 15th April se chalo ho rahe hamare exams. Then which preposition you have to use here? Our examination begin on. Our examination begin on 15th April. The next one, I had a message dash friend. I had a message from friend, we can say. I had a message for friend. We can use here both for and from. I had a message for friend. Friend के लिए message है. Then from, I had a message from friend. Both we can use here. From means friend से message मेरे लिए है. और I had a message for friend means friend के लिए message है. Then ninth one, he hit her dash the head with a bottle. You know the meaning of this sentence. He hit her dash the head with a bottle. Where he hit? On the head. Here which preposition is used? He hit her on the head with a bottle. The next goes to 10th example. Neeta was angry dash what I had said. Neeta was angry. What I had said. The preposition used here is at. Because Neeta was angry at what I had said. जो भी मैं बताया उसके लिए नीता क्या है? She was very angry. Then 11th one. This is an idea I entirely agree with. This is an idea. I entirely agree. Means I am going to agree with that idea. I am going to agree means I entirely agree with that. I entirely agree with that idea. Then 12th one. Please convey my best wishes dash him. It's very easy. Please convey my best wishes. इसको भेज रहे तुम बेस्ट विशेस to him. Please convey my best wishes to him. The 13th one, he inquired dash me what he should do. He inquired dash me what he should do. He inquired of me. He inquired of me what he should do. He inquired of me. मेरे बारे में इंक्वायरी करे उन्होंने. What he should do. क्या करना है. Then 14th one. Please inform me dash the details of him. Please inform me dash the details of the scheme. That is scheme के बारे में पूरा जानकारी दे दो मुझे. पूरे उसके बारे में means about the scheme. 14th one is about the details. About the details of the scheme. Next 15th one is I request you to intimate dash me what you should do. I request you to intimate to me means inform me what he should do. Intimate to me means inform me. Then 16th one, students must options for the three courses offered means OPT means optional. That is students must optional for two of the three courses offered. 17th one is he prayed dash God for help. He prayed dash God for help. He prayed to God for help. Very easy that is. 18th one, they presented him dash with a gold watch. They presented him with a gold watch. Gold watch उन्होंने present करें. 19th one, please refer dash your letter of July. Please refer to your letter. Then 20th, that is last one, this figure is wrong. Please strike it off. Off means this is wrong. Please cut that one. Please off that one. So what we have discussed today, that is the articles and prepositions completely. That is bit A we have discussed in the previous class, and completely bit B and bit C is also discussed. We have discussed in the today's class. So what you do tomorrow, the D option, that is D option, fill in the blanks with suitable articles or prepositions. In this class and in the previous class, we have discussed separately about the articles and the preposition. But what next they have given? They have given combinedly. We have to use article and we have to use preposition. So fill in the blanks with suitable articles and prepositions. They have given a paragraph. Complete paragraph is there in the 15th paragraph. So what you do? Read each and every paragraph. I will tell you only two lines. East Tawain contains a Hurrian and Tetum countries. Dash area. Here in this dash, what you have to use? Whether you have to use articles or whether you have to use preposition. You are completely confused about this articles and the preposition. On the basis of this, what we have learned yesterday and today, that is articles and the preposition, on that knowledge, they have given the combined gaps there. That is the reason you have to find out where we have to use articles and where we have to use prepositions. Dash area. I will give you only one clue, that is the area covers 8,143 square kilometers, about 1/5 of Tawain's total area, but has dash population. Again here, whether you have to use preposition or article, that is a population of only 6,10,000 or just 3% here, 3% of the population of Tawai. Like this, we have to classify the preposition and the articles. So you study all this, complete the paragraph which is given in the 15th, page number 15, and try to fill up the gaps. So if you try this one, and we will discuss this in the next class. Thank you.